Australia, baby. Almost died. This is the third time that I've been through crazy turbulence. The first time wasn't that bad. It was just like, yo, this is crazy. Second time, it was like everybody made the same, like a roller coaster, you make this involuntary. Everybody did that. And that's when I realized, I used to think it was stupid for people to wear seatbelts on the plane. Like, what? If it go down, the seatbelt ain't gonna help. But I understood why. Because when you go down, you can fucking go up and you're not gonna, you know. Anyway, today, it was, I don't know if it was 5 or 10 seconds of drop. And people didn't make that involuntary sound, people were screaming. It was crazy. My heart was pounding hard. I was texting my kids that I love them. You know, but I didn't die. But did you die though? Around here. We got Tasha here, we got Uncle T over there. We got Isaac behind the lens. And we're gonna have a good time in Australia. Sydney. All right, so check it out. Before we really get into this vlog, I want to send a big shout out to Audible. I've been using Audible for a long time. I'm excited that they care about me enough to want to partner with me. But anyway, I want to give y'all a link, my link, audible.com/haterproof. I want to share with you guys a book that I'm reading right now, a new book. I usually have the same rotation of books, stuff that I really like, but this is a new book. It's called The Complete Guide to Fasting. The author is Dr. Jason Fung. He's a nephrologist. And, you know, and nephrologists, they study kidneys, high blood pressure, fluid retention, things of that nature. So he's an authority on the matter. And a lot of people think that I'm just pulling this one meal a day and fasting and this plant-based eating is out of the sky. It's people like this who I'm getting this information from. But anyway, this book is really good, really informative. It really puts a lot of things in perspective and puts you in check about your health, things that you don't see. So use my link, audible.com/haterproof. You get a free 30-day trial. Use it for free. For audiobooks, I can't tell you the last time I read a book. I used to read a lot of books. I don't now. I'm just on the go at all times. So much information available to us at any given time. It's very efficient on my time to be able to be in my car or on a plane and listen to a book, you know? So check the link. All right, now into this vlog.
Yeah, I do it for a bet.
All right, so a long time ago, I was at my homegirl Shelly's house. She was young and it was a house full of people. College days. Uh-huh. And there's like 80 people in her apartment. And it was these two dudes. It was the weirdest friendship. It was a normal dude and a dude with some kind of developmental disability. And they were roommates. It was weird. So somebody knocked on the door. You know, and whatnot. You think it's the cops.
Automatically.
Oh, it's police. So everybody ran to the balcony. We knew it wasn't a cops. Whoever came in by that time. Uh-huh. But the slow dude.
Oh, he dove out?
He was trying to impress everybody. He's like, I'll jump. It was the three stories, right? Second floor, I'll jump. The three, you don't do that. So he was like, I'll jump. And then my stupid ass was like, I was like, oh shit, it's them. Go. I'm gonna go after you. Yo, him jumping wasn't the funny part. How he landed was funny. His tailbone. So it was like that. That pain. And then his roommate.
Master, huh?
Yeah. But it hurt.
It don't hurt.
It probably that's truncated his spine. He probably 3 inches shorter. Roommate run down there. Hey, you stupid. Get up. Like he's embarrassed.
Funniest shit ever.
Yeah. Anyway, moral to the story is I'll jump. I'll parkour the fuck out of this.
You make a distance.
Sydney, Australia. are these Sydney trees? These are like jungle trees. You know that these kind of trees. That ain't no regular palm tree, dude. Look at that palm shit. Tree. You
you could make a hut out of that, out of those fucking.
We are heading over to UFC gym. Try and get it in with one of my homies. Yeah, last time y'all see me and him together was in Miami. So now we in Australia. Y'all see us getting after it. Alright? How about that?
William Wack. I'm knackered, that's what I'm doing, man. Oh shit, I'm fucking knackered, but I don't do it, don't do it, I want to sleep, but I'm not doing it. I slept on the plane though, yeah, that's what I'm saying, I slept on the plane, I was still tired, yeah, no, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to stay awake and sleep normal time, because otherwise I'm just gonna mess up completely, I think I'm gonna be up all night though, so I don't give a fuck, whatever, who do you sleep?
I'm riding around in my car's low. What you waiting for? I feel like I hit the lotto. What you waiting for? I'm riding around in my girl's eye. What you waiting for? We're riding around just to get by. What the fuck you waiting for? I'm riding around in my car's low. What you waiting for? I feel like I hit the lotto. What you waiting for? I'm riding around in my girl's eye.
Tutorial.
Just hit the little button right there.
Yeah. All right. So the workout was good. I got the link up with my brother Simeon Panda. Yeah, no, that's my bro right there. I love him to death, man. A good dude. And he brought William the Beast. It's this Nigerian nightmare over here. You know what I'm saying? And, we had a real good time, man. We bond through training. And the people here at UFC Sydney showed a lot of love. Really, really good atmosphere, dope vibe in the gym. What more can you ask for? So, I already ate today, so they need to eat. And that's a wrap.